Very good morning. I'm Shilpa and I welcome you all again to the CIT NCERT live phone-in program. In English language, we do use a, an, the. These are called articles. Most of us get confused when to use articles. So let's discuss what articles are, why to use them and how. With us we have Ms. Pooja Sehgal from Sarvodaya Kanya Vidyalaya number 1, Keshavpuram, Delhi. And she is an assistant teacher at Directorate of Education. I welcome you, Ms. Pooja.
Thank you, Shilpa.
And to the viewers, if you come across any questions related to our today's topic of discussion, then you can call on our toll-free numbers. Numbers are 1-800-111-265 and 1-800-111-2199. You can also send your questions on our official email ID, ciet.kishoremanch@gmail.com. This session on our official YouTube channel, which is NCERT Official. So you can also comment your questions there. So Ms. Pooja, please do tell our viewers what articles are.
Good morning, children. Today we'll be talking about articles which you are already familiar with. You have been studying it since class 3, class 4, and articles are a and the. But in class 3, class 4, you have read more about a and an. And today we'll be exploring more on articles. Along with a and an, we'll be exploring more on the also. So we have three articles, a, an, and the, and we'll be talking about these three articles. So let's quickly brush up what we already know, as we have already read these articles in class 3 and class 4. First of all, when we talk of articles, the first thing that comes to our mind or that teacher tells us is vowels and consonants. Now, what are these vowels and consonants? See, children, you know English alphabet consists of 26 letters. I have all the 26 letters with me. You can see here, I have all the 26 letters. And out of these 26 letters, we have 5 vowels. A, E, I, O, and U. And the rest other 21 letters are consonants. Now, when we talk of vowel and consonants in articles, we always talk about its sound. We never talk about letters. So, many children do this mistake. They just check the vowel letter and the vowel, the vowel letter and consonant letter, and they just write the articles accordingly. But today I'll tell you exactly what to do. We don't have to check the letters, we just have to check the sounds. Now, when we start with sound, this one vowel letter can have more than one sound. It is like if we talk about A, we have sound A as in apple, as in ant. And we have another sound A, which is in aunt. So we have two sounds. Similarly, for E, we have more than one sound. In elephant, it is A, and in eagle, it is E. So, we have more than one sound for any of the letters we can have. But you don't have to worry. Why? Because other than English, we are also learning one more language. Few are learning some mother tongue, their mother tongue, their regional languages. So, in every language, we have these vowel sounds. Like in Hindi, we have swar and vyanjan, and these swar are actually vowel sounds. Can anybody tell me what are swar? Which letters we go for swar? Which sounds? Shilpa, do you have any idea?
Pooja, I think we'll wait students to reply. They have heard your question. Meanwhile, you can just go ahead. So if they'll answer, I'll come back to you.
Okay. Let me tell you, स्वर हमारे कौन से स्वर होते हैं? It is a, आ, ई, ई, ओ, ऊ, ए, ए, ओ, ओ. So we just have to go by this स्वर माला to check the vowel sound. So for example, let me clear these things with the example. I have this car. It's on my table. This car. Now, car starts with which sound? Is it a vowel sound? K. It is beginning with K. Is it a vowel sound? Just think of swar. A, A, I, I, U, U, A, A, O, O. No, it is starting with K. That means it is a consonant sound. And for consonant sounds, we put A. And for vowel sounds, we put an. So for every noun, for a person or a thing, when it begins with a vowel sound, we'll put an. And if it begins with a consonant sound, we'll put a. Now, for instance, another example I am giving you. Okay. There's one thing on my table. What's this? It's a bird, a big bird. It's an ostrich. Since it is starting with O, and O is our vowel sound, how could we get it that it is a vowel sound? Because just go through the sounds. A, A, I, I, U, U, A, A, and O, O. And this is O, ostrich. So it is a vowel sound. And if it is a vowel sound, we'll put an in front of this word. So I'll say it is an ostrich. Is it clear? Okay.
Yes.
So now I think we have already done this in class 3 and class 4 also. I have also told you about the vowel sound and consonant sound. So let me give you more examples. I'll show you one picture and you have to tell me whether we'll be putting A or whether we'll be putting an with that word. But you have to be fast, children. A girl. It's a girl. Why? Because girl is starting with sound G, which is a consonant sound. And with consonants, we always put A. Another example. What is this, children? Elephant. A elephant or an elephant? An elephant. Why? Because elephant is starting with vowel sound A. But children, we have to remember one more thing. This is a engine or an engine?
It again has A in it.
Very
engine.
Good. Its so sound is A, right. Sorry, its sound is E because we say it, we call it engine, E. And E is an R vowel sound. A, A, E, E. Remember I told you? Just go by this sound test. So this is E. And we'll say an engine. But one thing which I was telling you that we have to remember is we use A and an only for singular things. Why? Because it means one. If this is an engine, right? An engine. Now if I put another engine with this. We are having two engines, but I cannot say these are an engines. Why? Because it is not singular and an means one, but these are two. So we will not use a or an with plural things. Okay, so now I am giving you more objects. Just keep telling me with the vowel sounds. Is it a aeroplane, an aeroplane? Are we getting the answers,
so
Shilpa?
Anjana and Shilpa Dhariwal, yes, they both have replied and welcome before aeroplane.
Very good. And because we are starting this aeroplane with the sound air. Now be fast. A pencil and pencil.
I can say that it's a pencil because pa is not coming in any of the vowel sound.
Good. And what about and this, Shilpa? Is it a pencil or an pencil?
There are two pencils and you just mentioned that we use a and an for the singular things, not for the plural things.
Very good. These are two pencils, so we won't be using an or a. These are just pencils, two pencils. So I think this is very clear that we cannot use or an with plurals. Okay, ornament, an ornament. What is this? This is onion? No, this is onion. We call it onion. And onion, it is starting with vowel sound. So again it is an. I have so many toys for you. Just keep looking and keep answering. What is this? Table. A table. Consonant sound T. Chair. A chair. Consonant sound ch. Okay, I have a small drum. A drum. Consonant sound d. What is this, children? Shilpa, do you know what is this? I don't think Shilpa is knowing this. But children must be knowing. Okay, let me tell you, Shilpa, this is Avenger and we'll call it an Avenger. Why? Because again the vowel sound an is coming, right? Okay, it's a car, but if I say it's open car, then I'll say an open car. Right? Why? Because again open vowel sound. So children, we have learned that we do not use a or an with plurals. It is only for singulars. Secondly, we don't go by letters. We go by sounds, the vowel sounds and the consonant sounds. Because it sometimes happens like we have vowel letter but sound is not vowel sound. So we won't be writing an. For example, just look at this coin. It is 1 rupee coin. It starts with O and O is a vowel letter. So it should be a 1 rupee coin. Sorry, it should be an 1 rupee coin because it is starting with letter O, which is a vowel letter. But no, dear children, It might be starting with O, but the sound it is giving is a consonant sound. That is V. One. 1 rupee coin. It is V sound. And V is not a vowel sound. Because you can check in your sounds. Sound list. A, A, E, E, U, U, A, A, O, O. Again, no V sound is there. So, this is a consonant sound. So, we will say a 1 rupee coin. Similarly, if I say honest man, this honest man, we have the spellings H-O-N-E-S-T, honest, but it is a consonant, it is a word starting with a consonant letter H, but H is silent and the sound is honest, O, and O is a vowel sound. Since it is a vowel sound, we will use an honest man. Is it clear, children? Okay, so now I'll ask you I'll say a few sentences and you have to tell me if it is correct or incorrect. Shilpa, this is for you also. I will see you in an hour. Is it correct, Shilpa? I will see you in an hour. An hour. Very good. Right, Shilpa, you are right. It is correct. Why? Because I am saying an hour. Although the spellings of R is H-O-U-R, it is starting with a consonant letter H, but the sound is R. And it is starting with a vowel sound, which is A. Okay? Okay, we have one more sentence for you, children. There are 365 days in an year. There are 365 days in an year. Is it correct? An year.
Year. E. That's again a vowel. Okay. So, that's correct. An that's year. Correct.
Many children do this mistake. It is not correct. We always say a year. There are 365 days in a year. Why? Because the problem is sometimes we pronounce few things little here and there which changes its sound. This ear is not exactly ear. How we pronounce ear? It is year. A little sound of Y, year is coming. There are 365 days in a year. So, year is year, starting with year consonant. And it is not a vowel sound. Okay. Is it clear? So, yes. There is a difference.
Though you have already explained, but I think you need to explain it a bit more because students are still confused. Renuka, Mihir and Rakesh, they all are in class 5th and they are saying that, ma'am, if some alphabets are silent in a word, then why yes. are we writing those alphabets and why we are considering second alphabet? When to put A or N.
Okay. Listen, children. We have phonetics and I won't go deep in phonetics because it will be then another session and I have to stick to articles. We'll go for pronunciation and spellings in some other session where I'll be explaining you why we write letters but we don't speak of it. We keep them silent. We'll be going it in another session, okay? But here, the important point is that ear is not pronounced correctly. It is not, Y is not silent. It is giving a light sound, ear. So, that's why it is, though it is very confusing, people call it ear, but ear is this. this is ear, and yer is ear. So we'll put a ear and an ear, an earring. Okay, and these silent words we'll definitely take it in next session. Okay children, so I think you must have understood now where to use a, where to use an. So let's play a small game. I have brought some toys for you, so let's play it. I'll keep few toys on the table, then I'll hide it, and you have to remember and recall their names. Okay, and I'll be calling their names, I'll be telling their names while keeping it on the table. Shilpa, you can also involve in this activity. I'm keeping it on the table and I'll giving you the names. A teddy bear, a boy, a fish. I'm keeping all the articles of a letter, a sound. A lion. I must keep it like this, it is more clear. A drum. A box. A chair. A coin or a 1 rupee coin. A bell. Shilpa, be careful, you have to tell me all the names later. Okay. A table. A car. A chili. Okay, how many articles we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Fine, Shilpa?
Okay.
Okay, now children, get ready to answer before Shilpa Didi does. Here it goes, like this. Now, tell me.
I have to recall all the articles you kept there?
Yes, 12 articles.
Okay, 12 articles. I remember the first one, chili, because that was the last one you said, chili.
A chili.
A chili.
A chili.
A table.
I didn't hear you.
A table.
A table.
A car.
A car.
And a bell.
A bell.
A box.
A box. Children, you can help Shilpa Didi.
Because I am forgetting few articles, you can help me actually. A drum.
A drum.
A lion.
Yes, a lion.
Lion was there. Okay. And fish, you had said at the very starting. A fish.
A fish.
Okay. And the rest of the articles I'm not able to
first
recall.
First article, you forgot the biggest one.
Okay. A letter.
I didn't hear you.
A letter.
Letter. Letter.
Yes, letter.
No, there was no there? Letter.
Okay, I heard it later. Okay, so the rest of the articles I am not able to recall.
Okay, anybody helping you?
No.
It's okay. So let's see what you missed. You missed a boy, a teddy bear, and a coin, a car. That's it. Others you were... You took all the names. So you got 8 out of 12.
Coin, you have said it's 1 rupee coin.
A coin or a 1 rupee coin, both will go.
Okay. Okay, okay.
I just wanted children to know it is not an 1 rupee coin since it is starting with O, but that is not the sound. Sound is W. 1 rupee. So coin or okay. 1 rupee coin, both will be using. Okay, Shilpa, now I'll be giving you things of an. Now you have to be more careful. Let's perform better than before. An ostrich. An umbrella. An onion. An aeroplane. An elephant. An envelope. This is envelope. An ice cream stick. An Avenger. An ornament. An eyeshadow palette. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this is an engine. An open car. Shilpa, I hope you are not writing
what
it on.
What the last one you said?
An open car.
Okay.
So, shall I start? Shall I cover it?
Yes.
Okay, Shilpa. Yes. We can start
okay,
it
so
now.
This time, I have tried to give more attention to what you are saying.
If Shilpa, if okay. I say, just tell me in sequence then.
In sequence? Okay, that's the task.
It's okay. I'm just joking. You can all okay. do it.
So, the first one is an ostrich.
An ostrich.
An umbrella.
An umbrella. You are doing it in sequence. Good.
An aeroplane.
An aeroplane.
An onion.
Very good. An onion.
An ice cream.
An ice cream. Not an ice cream. Something else. Ice cream.
Ice cream stick. Yes. An ice cream stick. And an envelope.
An envelope. Good.
An elephant.
An elephant.
Okay. One word you had taught us. That was an Avenger.
An Avenger.
And
Shilpa learned
ornament.
It so fast. Huh? Avenger, she learned it.
An ornament.
An ornament.
What was
I
more?
Think you are just left with two.
Okay. One was one an eyeshadow palette.
Very good, an eyeshadow palette.
Okay, what I am left with?
You are left
yes,
with
yes,
something.
Yes, I remember.
Yeah.
I remember.
You asked
I remember
me twice.
With the help of a cartoon. An engine.
I didn't get this.
An engine.
Engine. You are still left with one, Shilpa. You asked me twice for that word.
Okay, that was something related to car. Okay, an
yes.
open car.
Very good. 12 out of 12,
okay.
Shilpa. Good.
Okay.
Okay, now I think now let me sum up. What we have done till now, first of all, we use a and an with singular things, not with plurals. Secondly, we go with vowels and consonant sounds, not with letters, because sometimes we have silent letters and sometimes we have different sound. And now one more thing I would like to tell is we cannot write a or an with uncountable nouns. What does that mean? For example, we cannot say a milk, a sugar, a water. Why? Because milk, sugar, water, honesty, these things are uncountable. And we cannot write a milk. We can say a glass of milk. Why? Because glass is countable, but milk is not. So we cannot say give me a milk or take a milk. We always say take a packet of milk, give a packet of milk, a glass of milk, or a glass of water, a cup of water, but never with uncountables. We say a milk, a glass, a sugar, or honesty. Okay, so three things: singular, vowel sounds and consonant sounds, and with countables, not with uncountables. Okay, now, and we also learnt about how we correctly pronounce ear. It's not ear, it's ear. Fine. Okay, now we are clear with usage of a and an. Now let's come to usage of the, which I think is an additional information for you class 5. I have few slides for you for the usage of the. So let's see where we use the. When we talk of a particular person or thing, we use the. For example, I am talking about a common person, a boy. A boy was standing near the tree. I don't know who the boy is, but if I know who the boy is and I say, where is Ram? Oh, the Ram, sorry, where is boy? The boy is standing near the tree. That means I am particularly talking about a boy. You can see in the slide, I have an example, open a window. It can be any window. So, we are saying a window. But if I particularly want you to open window on your left, I'll say open the window on your left. It means it is not any window. It is that particular window which is on your left. Similarly, if I say take a chair please, so that means I want to say take any chair. But if I say take the chair lying near the door, that means I want you to take that particular chair which is lying near the door. So when we talk of a person or a thing, particularly about that person or thing, we use the. Let's go to the next slide. When we speak of a thing or a person for the second time, first time when I speak of it, when I mention it, I'll say a. But when I'll again mention the thing, I'll say the. He showed me a box. The box was full of chocolates. When he showed me a box, I didn't know about it. But now the second sentence is talking about the box again. So we are saying a box, and then the box was full of chocolates. Again I'm mentioning box. It will come as the box. And the next slide is, a puppy ran after me. I did not know about the puppy, so a puppy, any puppy. But later I realized and I talked about the puppy was cute and friendly. So we are using it for the second time, and we'll be using the. Next we use the with superlatives. In the last session also I told you about superlatives, that we use the with superlatives. The most beautiful girl, the most dangerous animal, the largest box, the best student. And we use the with things which are one of their kind, like the sun, the moon, the earth. It is one of their kind. We don't have another sun, we don't have another moon, or we don't have another earth. Next, we use it with ordinal numbers. I got the first prize, first, last, 22nd, next, the next child, the last bench. And And this is very important. We use the before the names of rivers, seas, oceans, newspapers, holy books, famous buildings, ships. So we use the with all these. Okay, children. Now we have done A and the, and it is the assessment time. So I have few questions for you. Can we have the slide? You have to complete the blanks with A and the or zero. Zero means no articles. No articles with things which are uncountable. So let's quickly do this. Vishal has got dash dog, a dog. Second part, what is dash dog's name? We are again mentioning that dog, so we'll say what is the dog's name. In the first sentence, a, second sentence, the. Why? Because we are mentioning the dog again. Do you want an orange? Because O is vowel sound. She was dressed in a uniform. Why? Because uniform. Here is consonant sound. Next is, an ostrich has the biggest egg in all the birds. Children likes sweets. No A, no an, no the. Why? Because sweets are uncountable. Children like sweets. How far is dash sun from dash earth? Sun and earth both are one of their kind. So we'll write the. And the last one is, I will be back in dash r. An R. Why? Because it is a vowel sound. So children, you just complete these exercises. You can comment if you have any confusion or any doubt. So children, I'll be waiting for your doubts, your confusions if you have any. And you can do this practice at home, and you can write anything in the comment. I'll get back to you. So children, this is all for today. Thank you. Bye.